Want a great picture for your webcam but aren't willing to pay $500 or more for a proper APS-C or full-frame camera with clean HDMI out? Then another $100 or more for a capture card? Plus a dummy battery? You know, it all adds up. So what if I told you you could have the same results for what I'm currently filming this video with, including a mirrorless camera, a proper lens that will do background blur, a dummy battery so it can run as long as you want to, and a capture card, all for just a little over $200. Stick around and I'll share the secret with you, and I've put links to everything I'll present in this video in the description below. Now, one small thing to note here is there is a tiny bit of work that you'll need to do to tweak the camera for the clean HDMI out that you'll need here. That process takes around 10 minutes to do, but in the end, it'll be worth it and you'll save a few hundred dollars. So let's get started. So the first thing you'll need in this case is the camera. Now, I've done a ton of research on this and on a couple of mirrorless cameras that come with clean HDMI out capability that's built in. First, the Sony A5100 is a great camera and more or less started the movement as streamers and YouTubers transitioned from their native USB webcams to proper mirrorless cameras. But they still fetch about $400 on average on eBay, and the newer A6000 and A6100 plus the ZV-1s, those sell for $400 to $700 as well in the secondhand market. Even just 14 months ago, APS Box posted a video on these cameras, and in the used market, they've nearly doubled in average price over the past year. Now, another great camera with clean HDMI out, by the way, is the Canon M200, which is a four-year newer model, and you can still buy those new right now with a great kit lens for about $550 on Amazon. Generally after that, things start to get a bit more expensive, north of $1,000 for quite a few of them, especially if you want something with a full-frame sensor. So check out the link in the description from Elgato for a comprehensive list of all the cameras that have clean HDMI out. Now, the secret to the camera I'm recommending here being the cheapest is probably at least partly due to the fact that it isn't on this list, because technically, you need to do a little bit of firmware modification to make this camera output clean HDMI and 1080p video. So what's the camera, you ask? It's the Sony A5100's little brother, the Sony A5000. Now, these cameras often tend to go for under $200 used on eBay, and even cheaper if you can find one on Craigslist or OfferUp. There was another video posted by the Ice Orb channel last April, but this approach used OBS to crop out the bottom 10% or so of the frame to remove any on-screen display over HDMI, which would kind of net you around 1600 by 900 pixels and require that you use OBS or some other software to crop the image if you want to use it for things like Microsoft Teams or for Zoom meetings. And you don't need to do that anymore. So I actually purchased a Sony A5000 without a lens or battery, also known as body only, in almost mint condition for just $135 with free shipping from Korea. Now, full disclosure, mine took around a month to arrive. So you may need to find something a little bit more expensive and closer to you if you don't want to wait as long as I did. Now, if you find one like mine that is body only, you'll need to pick up a lens too, but if you can find an A5000 with a kit lens for around $200, then you can save your money for that lens. And I knew I didn't want a battery in my case or a lens, so the body-only option was perfect in my case. And in the spirit of keeping within low budget, there are two manual focus lenses on Amazon that are great for webcam applications with the ability to do background blur as well, and both of those are linked in the description below. The first one is the Neewer 25mm f1.8 lens, and the second option is the Micro 28mm f2.8 lens for Sony E-mount cameras. Now, I was able to get the Neewer lens on sale for $42, so that brought my running total to $177. So now you'll need a way to constantly power the camera, and for that, you'll need what's called a dummy battery. So for Sony, this basically sends a constant 8.4 volts to your camera, so it thinks the battery is always full. And the one I purchased is linked in the description below, and it was $20 on Amazon. That brings me to a total of $197. But now you'll need a micro HDMI to HDMI cable in order to send the image from the camera to your computer. And those tend to run for about $7 for a 6-foot cable, and I've linked to a few of those in the description as well. And be sure to get the length that you want depending on how far your camera will be from your computer. And finally, where the real magic happens to convert your camera's HDMI feed into a webcam feed for your PC, Mac, or Linux computer, for that you're going to need a capture card. And you can go for the $100 plus Elgato Camlink 4K, which honestly has a bit better sharpness and color reproduction than the cheaper ones out there. But I've tested a few of those cheaper ones, and the unbranded ones that have the small pigtail USB cable seem to be the best ones that I've personally tried, and they're about $17. And again, I have a link to a few of those that I've personally tested in the description. Now, for some reason, I've had better luck with the ones that have the USB wire compared to the fatter ones without the wire coming out of them. And I've tried around 10 different types in this price range, and these have worked out best for me. So the image is a little bit warmer than the Cam Link, and everything's a bit more contrasty, but the image that you're seeing now is actually from a Sony A5000 with one of those capture cards, so you can correct most of the color variances using the settings in the camera. So that then brings my total investment to $221 before tax, and including shipping, assuming that you have Amazon Prime. And to put this into perspective, that's about $23 more than a Razer Kiyo Pro, $25 more than a Logitech Brio, and $33 more than the AverMedia PW513 webcams that are selling for new on Amazon right now. Now, to be clear, these normal webcams will be pretty easy to set up with a lot fewer moving parts, but the image quality won't be nearly as good, and you won't be able to change lenses or truly fine-tune your focus, exposure, white balance, color tint, etc. And you can't get the background blur or comparable dynamic range from any webcam with their tiny sensors, and I've tried all of the good ones. So now, as I mentioned in the beginning, there's one more thing you have to do once your Sony A5000 arrives to make it have clean HDMI out, and that's to follow the tutorial that's linked in the description on how to get clean HDMI out working with your A5000. Now, this process basically involves you downloading three files, installing two lightweight apps, two of those files, on your Windows or Mac computer, then installing an Android app on the camera because the camera runs Android, and finally sending it three commands over a PuTTY terminal command line window. And you can install and power it with the dummy battery that you purchased and use a micro USB cable to do all of this. It takes about 10 minutes. In fact, it was so easy that I did in fact buy Cyrix a coffee in the end for £5, which then brought my total investment up to $227, but that last expense is optional and up to you. Finally, I'll walk through basic camera settings that I've set up on my camera so that you can get a clean image out of yours. First, in shoot mode, I've set mine to movie and aperture priority. In aspect ratio, by default, this was set to 3x2, but I've set mine to 16x9. The fourth menu over is where you'll set white balance to match the lighting temperature in your room. And there are a bunch of great presets that you can try out, or you can manually adjust it like I've done here at 5100 kelvins to match my lighting. But your settings will vary depending on your lighting temperature. So the rest of the settings I've more or less left as is, and then all the way to the right in the setup tab, the icon there that looks like a toolbox, make sure that HDMI resolution is set to 1080p, and that's about it. Then there are two small but livable nuisances with this camera. So the first one is when you power it on compared to the Sony A5100 or A7 Mark II that I own, that don't do this, the A5000, you'll need to hit the play button on the back of the camera to clear the file menu each time you power it up. Now, there might be a way to disable this and go straight to the camera feed, but I personally couldn't find it. And that takes it from a one-step process to power it on to a two-step operation when you're using the camera. And if you know for a solution for this, by the way, please leave a comment below. Second is the automatic skin smoothing effect from Sony. It makes you look a little waxy and it makes your wrinkles or skin color variances go away. And this is the same on the Sony A5100. Now, you might like this effect, but personally I don't. So to kill it, you just use the digital zoom on the shutter button to go up one tap clockwise to where it says 1.1. And then you can tap it back gently counterclockwise so it almost goes back to zero but still reads 1.1 on the screen. Now, that disabled skin smoothing nets about 5% zoom in as opposed to 10%, and the resulting 5% is almost unnoticeable. So now you're set and you just need to mount the camera on a tripod, select it as your webcam on your computer or in your preferred streaming or online meeting app, then fine-tune your aperture and focus to your liking. Now, one last pro tip here, as cool as the bokeh effect is, I like to set my aperture to around 2.5 to 3.5, otherwise you can't really move forward or backward without dropping out of focus, but that's a personal preference thing, and if your room is messy and your lens supports it, then you might want to crank that aperture up to 1.8 or lower. Then you'll have your blurry background, your cinematic setup, and you're ready to go and start creating content or just impressing people in your upcoming online meetings. So if you like this tip, be sure to subscribe and I'll be adding more of my personal tech experiences for working from home or in the hybrid office environment. And as always, thank you so much for watching and I hope to see you again soon.